The Red Star. Mira was a proud member of the Red Star Collective. She had been born and raised on the space station that orbited planet Zeta. She'd never seen the surface of the planet, but knew it was a wasteland. The capitalists had ruined it with their greed and pollution. They'd exploited the workers and the resources until nothing was left. The Red Star Collective was a group of rebels who fought against the capitalists. They had seized control of the space station and declared it a socialist utopia. They shared everything equally and worked together for the common good. They had a vision of restoring the planet and creating a new society based on justice and harmony. Mira was a pilot. She flew a fighter ship that defended the space station from the capitalist attacks. She loved her job. She felt like she was making a difference. She hated the capitalists with all her heart. She wanted to see them suffer and pay for what they had done. Mira was skilled and fearless pilot who loved the thrill of flying in space. She wears a sleek, functional suit that protects her from harsh conditions of outer space and enhances her performance. She has a helmet with a visor that displays vital information that allows her to communicate with her team. She pilots a state-of-the-art fighter spacecraft that is fast, agile, and armed with powerful weapons. She is loyal to her mission and ready to face any challenge or enemy. She is a hero and a leader who inspires others with her courage and charisma. One day, she was assigned to a special mission. She was told to infiltrate the capitalist ship and sabotage its engine. She was given disguises, a fake identity. She boarded the ship as a passenger and waited for her mission report. Lena was a scientist. She worked for the Red Star Collective Agency, a communist government-funded organization that explored the outer reaches of the solar system. She was part of a team that was sent to investigate a strange anomaly near the outer belt of the capitalist system. It was a blue spot that appeared on the radar, but no one knew what it was. She boarded the spaceship with her colleagues and set off for the mission. She was curious and excited. She hoped to discover something new and amazing. The journey took several months. They spent most of their time in cryo sleep, but occasionally woke to check the status of the ship and the anomaly. They noticed that the red spot was getting bigger and brighter as they approached it. They also noticed it was emitting some kind of strange signal. They couldn't decipher it. They finally reached the destination. They woke from their cryo sleep and prepared to launch a probe into the anomaly. They activated the probe and watched it on the screen as it flew towards the blue spot. They expected to see some kind of planet or asteroid or comet, but they saw something else. They saw a giant eye. It was blue and glowing and staring right at them. It blinked and moved and followed their movements. It looked alive, intelligent, angry. Zara was an explorer, a pioneer, a seeker of the unknown. She had traveled to many planets and stars, but none of them satisfied her curiosity. She wanted to see something truly alien, something beyond her imagination. She is a brave and adventurous explorer who loves to discover new worlds and cultures. She wears a red uniform that symbolizes her loyalty to the Space Communist Agency, which aims to create a fair and equal society across the galaxy. She works for the Planetary Exploration Division, which is responsible for scouting and surveying potential planets for colonization. She has a helmet and a visor that displays her vital information and allows her to communicate with her team. She carries a backpack with various tools and devices such as scanner, laser cutter, grappling hook, and jetpack. She also has a blaster pistol for self-defense. She is curious and friendly, but also cautious and alert. She is always ready to face any challenge or danger that might arise in her missions. She is a pioneer and a visionary who dreams of creating a better future for humanity. She'd heard rumors of a creature that lurked deep in space, a creature so strange and terrifying that no one ever seen it and lived to tell the tale. It was called the Space Beholder, and it was said to have a spherical body covered with eyes and tentacles, each with a different power. Some could shoot lasers, some could freeze objects, some could manipulate gravity, and some could even alter reality itself. Zara was not afraid of the Space Beholder. She was fascinated by it. She wanted to be the first one to encounter it and study it. She wanted to unlock its secrets and learn its origins. She wanted to see the world through its many eyes. She spent years searching for clues and traces of the Space Beholder's existence. She followed leads and rumors, scanned anomalies and signals, chased comets and asteroids. She was determined to find it, no matter the cost. One day she finally got a breakthrough. She detected a faint but unmistakable signal coming from the remote sector of the galaxy. It was unlike anything she had ever heard before. It was a mix of static and whispers, screams and laughter, of madness and wisdom. It was the voice of the Space Beholder. She set a course for the source of the signal, ignoring all warnings and dangers. She knew she was close to her goal. She knew she was about to make history. She arrived at the coordinates and saw nothing but darkness. She scanned the area with her sensors and instruments, but they showed no life, signs of life or matter. She wondered if she had made a mistake or someone had played a trick on her. Then she saw it. It emerged from the shadows like a nightmare, a huge sphere of flesh. Zara felt a surge of fear and awe as she beheld the Space Beholder. It was bigger than her ship. Its eyes and tentacles were constantly moving and shifting. She could feel its presence in her mind, chaotic and incomprehensible force that threatened to overwhelm her. She tried to communicate with it using the radio and her translator. She introduced herself and explained her purpose. She asked it questions about itself and its origins. She hoped it would respond and share its answers and knowledge with her. But the Space Beholder did not answer. It didn't seem like it cared about her words or her intentions. It only stared at her with its many eyes, examining her soul. Then it attacked. It unleashed a barrage of beams and rays from its tentacles, each with a different effect. Some burned, some froze, some distorted, some erased. Zara's ship was hit by it several times. She felt the pain and horror of the impact. She tried to evade and escape, but the Space Beholder was faster and smarter. It anticipated her every move, encountered her every defense, seemed to enjoy playing with her like a cat with a mouse. Zara realized that she had made a terrible mistake. She had underestimated the Space Beholder's power and intelligence. She had provoked it with her curiosity and arrogance. She had doomed herself with her ambition. She wished she had never heard of the Space Beholder. She wished she had never followed its signal. She wished she had never seen its eyes. But it was too late. The Space Beholder closed in on her ship, ready to deliver the final blow. Zara closed her eyes and waited for the end. She never saw a Space Beholder smile like a capitalist.